Good afternoon. This is the first part of a new large-scale testing and analysis of the image quality of media players, as there is a lot of material, so as not to make the video too long. I decided to release it in parts. The first part will be devoted to the image analysis when outputting SDR video 1080i and quality of de-interlacing. The following media players take part in the test. Some players require some pre-defaults to work properly. For on TV, for example, you need to put a patch to disable noise reduction on the image. For Dune, as well as for Zidu, it is necessary to switch to full range mode in HDMI and the second setting output in as in content mode. Otherwise, there will be problems with, first will not be processed levels, blacker than black and whiter than white, there will be problems with gradients and peaks for HDR video. Another option is to use the VS10 mode, but there are also problems with, for example, with the horizontal gradient. Tests I marked by numbers, not to get confused, the total was about 30 test patterns. The players are connected according to this scheme. HD Fury is used for bypassing HDCP on the sticks, as well as for the signal control feature, because it makes it very convenient to see what signal is really coming, and also for the possibility of enabling LLDV mode. HD Fury itself does not introduce distortions into the signal passing through, as it is able to pass a full 444 signal up to 16-bit, 4K60. The first test is the 001-003 tests for proper operation with blacker than black level, whiter than white and color clipping. It was done simply by recording video, and then in virtual dub we look how and what is shown. For example, this is a recording from Apple TV. It cannot output levels blacker than black and whiter than white. You see, it cuts off at 16 to 235. If you don't tweak it in the Dune player, it will be even worse. But the Apple TV has no such adjustments, so it's the only one that can't output levels blacker than black and whiter than white, and can't output colors above level 235. It turns out that all players passed these tests correctly, except Apple TV. It does not know how to process this and trims strictly by the level 16 to 235. But according to the standard, the color channels should work in 16 to 240 mode. But Apple has apparently forgotten about this. Actually, if you have seen my old tests, you know that it is because the processor always operates in computer image mode, 0 to 255. This is probably the reason for all the problems with this media player. Next are the tests to work with Interlace video. Perhaps many young users will say that this is an outdated format for video. And it is no longer relevant. But unfortunately, many concerts even in HD were released in this format. And also satellite recordings in most cases are also in this format, so I think it is an important thing. Test 004. This is a simple test. The video is compressed with the MPEG-2 Video 1080i codec. This is a screenshot from the original video, without de-interlacing. This is what it looks like. I saved all screenshots in paint.net to show and compare media players with each other. In this test, the on player performed the worst. You see, there is no second field and plus there was distortion on the diagonal lines. And Xiaomi Mi Stick also did not perform very well. Also, one field is output, and the second is not output at all. They made one half field and apparently tried to interpolate it into the second half frame. Apple TV did the same thing. But due to its powerful processor, it did it more accurately. Here is the Apple TV. Although it only outputs one half field, as you can see here there are no horizontal stripes, it still manages to output diagonal lines very well. Amazon Stick passed the test normally, outputting both half frames, but slightly spoiled their scores with poor diagonal lines. The Fire TV 4K, look, if you look closely, there are slight jagged lines on the diagonals. But, Fire TV Max actually outputs interlaced images even worse than its predecessor. all because of a rather primitive interpolation process. Most likely nearest neighbor. You can see how this striped square, red and blue, is rendered. The stripes are bold and very visible. It is because a primitive color interpolation system is produced. OPPO is the only player that can output video without deinterlacing. It can output the original 1080i stream. No one else can do this. It is possible that Zidu can do it. But unfortunately, some problems happen during the capture process. And for the time being, it will not participate. Therefore, in this test, unconditional victory at OPPO. Or rather, its clone, as it 100% brought out the same quality as the leaders, but at the same time, is able to output additional video without deinterlace. The other media players, Dune, Shield TV, X2 Cube, passed the test identically. The only difference is the difference in the brightness of the lines, and this is due to the different operation of color interpolation systems, as well as different internal processing, 444 or 422. The next test is 005. This clip is in 1080i format. But its difference from the previous template is the use of the Vc1 codec. Right away, I will make a remark about the Vc1 video codec. This format is obsolete, but blur discs were released in it up to 11 to 12 years, so a lot of movies and concerts were released in this format. So this format is extremely disliked by media players on Android. In fact, none of them cannot fully work with this format. The players either slow down immediately or after some time. At the same time, media players on Linux work with this format without problems. Concerts with Vc1 codec were also released in 1080i. As a result, we get a rattling mix. It is not only that Vc1 itself seems to be processed programmatically, but it is also necessary to deinterlace. For example, if you switch Yugu's X2 Cube to Core Elec mode, video from Vc1 is no problem for it, but in Android, this becomes a real problem. The video there lags, and it is clearly visible. Let's see screenshots of each player, how they worked out. This is the original frame without the deinterlace. This is how Media Player Classic did it. When I did the test, I had a GTX 1050T graphics card. I think some of the processing it did. Overall, not bad. By the way, I've changed my graphics card to a professional Quadro T600. It has a slightly updated unit for video processing, but I didn't do this test with it. Next. The Dune player, first of all, it outputs 29 frames instead of 59, the image twitches, but it is not yet deinterlaced. Although the stream itself is output as 59 frames, it's just that every second frame is a repetition of the previous one. So it failed this test. Amazon Sticks performed about the same, they just slow down on such videos, although the deinterlace itself was done quite well. Here is the Fire TV 4K. And this is the Fire TV Max. It looks like there is no difference between them in terms of deinterlacing quality. Xiaomi Mi 4K decided to output 59p as 29p. Like Dune Player. An even worse picture clarity. But at least it deinterlaced. Let me demonstrate how this happens. Look, I do a frame by frame preview. Pressed. There is movement. Pressed again, no movement. You see the frame changes, but the image does not, so the image shakes, it's twitchy and unpleasant to look at. ONNTV worked right. But it lacked the power of the processor. It did deinterlace itself quite well. At the level of Amazon players. But due to the fact that it is Android, and it is a Vc1 codec, the video lags. It is almost impossible to watch. The leader of this test is OPPO. Or rather an OPPO clone. Not only can it work well with Vc1, it can output video without deinterlacing. In its native 1080i format. It even deinterlays very well. Note the wire handling on the right, the wire looks great. Next is the Shield TV. Due to its fairly powerful processor, it was able to deinterlace, but it stretched the images by several pixels in height. And look at the wire. You can see he has ruined it. But overall, it passed this test with a 4. Next is the X2 Cube. It did the best job with the running line of text. Look at the clarity of the text. Even if you compare it to OPPO. And here is X2 Cube. You can see how clear and beautiful the text is. But it has a clear problem with the background. And the foreground is treated well. The Apple TV in this test, even with Yadav's best deinterlacing method, outputs 29 frames instead of 59. The video is clear enough, but twitchy. It's probably down to the developer of the Infuse player. Maybe someday they will be able to deinterlace properly, since as we know from my old tests, the Apple CPU should be more than powerful even for software processing. In fact, only the OPPO player was able to pass the 005 test. Shield TV with a stretch, we can say that it managed too. The next test is 029. It so happened that I did not add it at once, so it has this number. This is a fragment from an opera concert with Anna Netrebko and two tenors in H264 and 1080i format. Here is the usual codec for players that everyone can handle with hardware. So here we can see how well the deinterlace itself works. The Dune worked well. No obvious defects. Fire TV 4K did deinterlace correctly, but reduced the clarity, not much, but noticeable. Look at the faces, they are a little more blurry than they should be. The new Fire TV Max did worse as in the last test. Not only did it reduce the clarity, but it also deinterlaced with defects. You see, there were distortions in the faces. Xiaomi Stick on TV. OPPO clone. And Shield TV performed this task completely identically and quite well. There are no obvious defects. The Yugu's X2 Cube did the foreground well, but the backdrop gave away striping on the red elements. The Apple TV Dinterless did a good job, but it kept displaying 29 frames instead of 59, even though the stream itself was a 59-frame stream, just every second frame was a repetition of the previous one. Please note that the frame I output for the Apple TV is not identical to the frame I output for other players. The thing is, Apple TV combines two frames into one and gets a frame in the middle between the two original frames. That's why you don't get identical frames with others. This is the end of the first part, we will continue in the next part. Thank you all, subscribe to my channel, like, and wait for the next release, it will be soon. I have almost everything ready for the second part, where we will consider in detail the image quality in SDR, and possibly the quality of upscaling. Thank you for watching. Goodbye.